We'll see method of consistent deformation method or method of consistent deformations. Method of consistent deformations. It is also called compatibility method. So already we used this method for proper cantilevers. Okay, the method we used for proper cantilever is this only. So here the net deflection is summation of the individual deflection. So the concept is here net known deflection or net deflection equal to sum of, that means sum means here algebraic sum, downward and upward are having opposite signs, sum of individual deflections. So in proper cantilever, net deflection is zero. That means upward deflection equal to downward deflection. Suppose if you consider upward positive, downward negative, then upward minus downward equal to zero. That's why we know that for proper cantilever at proper support, net deflection is zero. So we use this method. So we can use this method for some other structures also. We will see one simple structure like this. Suppose a cantilever with some point load P, L by 2, constant EI. Suppose prop here, the level the prop is having some other, I mean prop is at some other level, and suppose there is a gap delta here, some G gap is there, okay? Gap G is there. How to analyze this problem? After applying load, I mean the gap is there before application. Gap G is there before application of load. Before application of load. So how to analyze this? How to find prop reaction here? We will see. So what is the downward deflection due to this load? By removing that prop, because of this P load, what is the downward deflection? See here, P L by 2 EI. This is the curvature diagram, right? This is curvature diagram for this. So now, the drag distance up to here is how much? You know, this is L by 2. This is 2/3 of L by 2. So now, downward deflection, delta L due to load, delta deflection equal to half into L by 2 into PL by 2 EI, area of this one, and into centroid distance up to the free end, because of, you know, moment area theorem 2. How to find deflection, okay? L by 2 plus 2 gets cancelled here, so L by 3, right? So which is equal to PL square by 8 EI multiplied by 5 L by 6, that equal to 5 by 48 PL cube by EI. That is the next net downward deflection, this one. Upward deflection we know due to reaction R, RL cube by 3 EI. So here compatibility is delta L minus delta R. See, earlier case it was zero. Now it is a gap G. That means 5/48 PLQ by EI minus RL³ by 3EI equal to G. Then from this we can find R. So R equal to R. Otherwise, RL³ by 3EI is equal to 5/48 PLQ by EI minus G. Or otherwise, R equal to 3A by L³ into 5/48 PLQ by EI minus G. Okay, that is the prop reaction R. If you know the G gap, you can find that prop reaction. Okay. So depend upon the G gap, you can find prop reaction R. We will see one more problem like this. Clear kada meeku andariki arthamaindi kada a gap G undadam valla reaction tagginda perigindha meeku or otherwise you cancel it 5/16 of P minus 3EIG by L³. So gap unte em avutundi chudandi ikkada gap G gap zero aithe reaction enta 5P/16. So gap undadam valla adi reaction ani tagutund anamata. Suppose meeku ee support sink ayind ankonde kindiki settle ayind ankonde ante aa support ganaka kinda saraina firm ground lekunda sink ayinattaithe settle ayinattaithe reaction em avutundi tagutund anamata. So aa sinking amount gap ni batti manaku reaction tagutundi. Enta tagutundante 3A/L³ to G and the amount anedi manaku decrease avutundannamata reaction. Okay, gap zero aithe 5P/16 gap unnataithe adi direct avutundi minus avutundi tagutundannamata. Okay, deeni compatibility condition antam edidi delta L minus delta R equal to G anedani compatibility condition R consistent deformations method ani kuda antam anamata deeni. Okay, doubts emanu ante adagandi. So clear ga unnaru? Okay, next. Suppose if there is a UDL like this, (10 kN/m), it is 4 meters. EI 10,000 kN/m². Now suppose
sir sir indaka meer cheppin danlo reaction at zero ayindante cantilever ki niku vastunda sir
proper cantilever idu kuda proper cantilever e
avun gaani ante appudu reaction zero ayindante aa position la adi normal cantilever aipothadu
reaction zero aitena yes ante reaction zero aipothe r zero aipothe cantilever kinduku vachestundi madam ante support ledani support chaala kindu undu anukodu daniki andaledu kada support chaala ekku gap undu anukodu. सपोज गैप आई मीन आ गैप 5P/16 आई मीन आर अने जीरो अको सपोज अंत गैप चला 5P/16 अंत अमौंट 3AG/L³ समथिंग माइनस समथिंग जीरो अवुतुंदि कदा अब आर जीरो अवुतुंदि अन्नमाट आर जीरो अयिपोते जस्ट अभी कैंडिलीवर किंदकि लेक्क इंका प्राप लेनट्टे लेक्क अन्नमाट नुव्वु सपोर्ट इच्चावु गानी एक्कडो किंद इच्चावु दानिकि अंदलेदु अन्नमाट अदि అర్థమైంది కదా
ఆ ఓకే సార్ అర్థమైంది సార్
నీ డౌట్ కరెక్ట్ అంతే కరెక్ట్ సో సపోజ్ లెట్ us హావ్ ఏ గ్యాప్ ఆఫ్ 2 mm హియర్ 2 mm ఓకే 2 mm గ్యాప్ బిఫోర్ అప్లికేషన్ ఆఫ్ లోడ్ before application of load. So 2 mm gap is there before application of load. So find prop reaction. point prop reaction. So what is delta L? Delta L is how much? Because of UDL, W L power 4 by 8 A, that is 10 into 4. L is 4, 4 to the power of 4 by 8 into 1000, 10,000 A. If you want to convert that into millimeters, multiply with 1000. What is the answer?
32.
How much?
32.
32 mm is the downward deflection. Okay. Now delta R is RL cube by 3 EA, which is equal to R, we don't know, L cube, 4 cube by 3, 10,000. This also we convert into millimeters. That equal to this 3 zeros and 3 zeros gets cancelled. 64 by 30 R. Otherwise, 32 R by 15 millimeters. Here we should be very careful. R is in kilonewtons, okay? Because A is kilonewton meter square, so R also in kilonewtons. The 32 R by 15 will be in mm now. So our compatibility is delta L minus delta R. That means downward deflection is delta L, upward deflection due to prop delta R, net deflection is 2 mm, 2. That means 32 minus 32 R by 15 equal to 2. This is the equation. So from this 32 R by 15 equal to 32 minus 2, that is 30. So from this R equal to 30 into 15 by 32. How much? 14.06. 06 kilonewtons. That is a prop reaction. So because of the gap or settlement of the support, otherwise it would be 15, right? Suppose the gap is not there, if 2 is not there, then it will be 0 and R would be 15. So because of 2 mm gap or 2 mm settlement, the reaction decreases to 14.06. Almost 1 kilonewton reaction decreased because of the settlement. So we'll see other kind, this kind of another this kind of problem, okay? Suppose there is a UDL like this, and suppose you have a spring like this here. Spring. Let us take, it is W kilonewton per meter, L span, EA. Let us take spring stiffness K equal to one fourth of L cube by A. Okay, find the prop reaction. Okay, same delta L, downward deflection is WL power 4 by 8A. After removing the prop, the downward deflection at support is WL power 4 by 8A. Prop reaction R, due to R, upward deflection is RL cube by 3A. So what is the spring settlement? Let us take, it is delta S. So now, if you draw a freeboard diagram, it will be like this. So some R reaction is getting, the spring is there in between, the spring also will get R force, R compressive force like this. Okay, so spring is experiencing R compressive force. So how can you define this stiffness of spring? Stiffness of spring K equal to, see, stiffness means load required to undergo unit displacement. That means force on the spring divided by delta. So force on the spring divided by delta is called stiffness. That means force required to cause unit displacement of the spring is nothing but stiffness. F by delta is K. That means if you want to find delta of spring, it is delta S, delta of spring if you want, that means compression of spring if you want to find, that is very simple, F by K, force by K. So the force in the spring is, that is F means force in the spring. Force in the spring, you know, what is that? R is the force in the spring. Whatever reaction is there, same amount of force will be there in the spring. K, stiffness, that is 1/4 of L cube by EI. Okay. Otherwise, we don't think. EA by L cube, take EA by L cube. That also we take 4 times of 4 a by l cube. So k is 4 a by l cube, that equal to r l cube by 4 a, that is the delta s. Now delta s is r l cube by 4 a. Now compatibility condition is downward deflection due to external loading minus upward deflection due to prop reaction is equal to net deflection, that is deflection of the spring, delta S. So here also use capital delta only, delta S here also. This is the compatibility condition. Delta L is WL power 4 by 8 EI minus delta R is RL cube by 3 EI equal to delta S RL cube by 4 EI. So from this, WL power 4 by 8 EI equal to RL cube by 4 EI plus RL cube by 3 EI. So WL power 4 by 8 EI equal to RL cube by EI common, 1 by 4 plus 1 by 3, 7 by 12. Okay. So EI gets cancelled. R equal to 12 by 7 into 1 by 8 into WL. That is 4 twos, 4 threes. So 3/14 of WL. This is the prop reaction. So like this, method of consistent deformations we can apply. We have spring like this. So doubt em ledhu indulo? Spring deflection gaani
sir malli appara sir, delta is correct
delta. So k definition entante force by delta anta, obvious ga delta em avutundante spring delta, delta s em avutundante f by k avutundi, adi clear kada?
Yes sir.
Ippudu force in the spring manaku prop reaction r anukuntunnam kada, automatic ga same r e niku spring lo vastund anamata, spring lo vache force same r e anamata, force in the spring vachesi r anamata. Spring delta, I mean spring yoke stiffness 4 a by l cube. So adi substitute chesam anamata, pothe niku delta s rl cube by 4 a vachind anamata. Just gurtu pettukovalasindi spring stiffness yokka definition anamata. Spring stiffness k ante force by delta ante oka unit displace avalante spring entha load kavali daniki anide stiffness anamata. సపోజ్ 1 mm డిస్ప్లేస్ అవ్వాలంటే ఎన్ని న్యూటన్స్ కావాలా, న్యూటన్ పర్ ఎంఎం అనేటట్టు ఉంటుంది అన్నమాట ఇది. ఓకే, స్టిఫ్నెస్ అనేది మీకు డెల్టా ఎస్ అర్థం అయిపోయిన తర్వాత డౌన్వర్డ్ డిఫ్లెక్షన్ లోడ్ వల్ల వచ్చే డౌన్వర్డ్ డిఫ్లెక్షన్ డెల్టా ఎల్ అనమాట, రియాక్షన్ వల్ల వచ్చేటువంటి అప్వర్డ్ డిఫ్లెక్షన్ డెల్టా ఆర్. ఈ రెండు కలిపితే నెట్ డిఫ్లెక్షన్ అవ్వాలా, దట్ ఈస్ డెల్టా ఎస్ అనమాట. నితీష్ క్లియరా?
అర్థమైంది.
తర్వాత అంతా ఆల్జీబ్రా అనమాట. ఓన్లీ నీకు ఇక్కడ డెల్టా ఎస్ అనుకోవడంలో ఎఫ్ బై కే అనేది అర్థం చేసుకోవాలన్నమాట. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ విల్ సీ వన్ మోర్ ప్రాబ్లం. సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ దెర్ ఇస్ ఎ సింప్లీ సపోర్టెడ్ బీమ్ లైక్ దిస్, and a cantilever is sitting like this on this, a load, some load 20 kilonewtons is acting like this, 2 meter 2 meter, the simply supported beam is 3 meter 3 meter. In 3D lo draw chesam meeku ardham avutundi kada. ఇది వచ్చి ఇక్కడ కూర్చుంది అనమాట, ఏది మన ఇక్కడ కూర్చుంది అనమాట, ఏది సింప్లీ సపోర్ట్ మీద సెంటర్ లో కూర్చుంది, ఏది క్యాంటిలివర్ యొక్క టిప్. స్ట్రక్చర్ అర్థమైంది మీకు? ఈ క్యాంటిలివర్ యొక్క టిప్ వచ్చి సింప్లీ సపోర్టెడ్ కి సెంటర్ లో కూర్చుంది అనమాట, అలా సింపుల్ గా రెస్ట్ అయింది దాని మీద. ఓకేనా? సో let us assume EA is constant everywhere, for I mean for cantilever as well as simply supported beam. Okay, EA is constant, we'll name it like this, A B C D. That means suppose if you separate these two structures it will be like this. See, this is the cantilever having 20 kilonewtons here. Okay, our aim is here find reactions, find reactions of simply supported beam. That is RC and RD. Okay, see, the simply supported beam is offering some reaction here for cantilever. Simply supported beam offering some support to the cantilever, and the cantilever is inducing same reaction on the simply supported beam like this. Okay, so that R is actually reaction between cantilever and a simply supported beam. So cantilever is experiencing 20 kilonewtons load, because of that some load goes to simply supported beam. That's why we are assuming R load is going to simply supported beam. That means exactly same R reaction the cantilever will get. So this is the splitted structure. Okay, splitted structure. Okay, now compatibility is what we'll see. Okay, suppose if there is no proper reaction R for cantilever, then what is delta L? Delta L equal to how much? We know delta L means, see here, this is the curvature diagram, that is bending moment is 20 into 240 by EA. So we need to find deflection at a B point, right? So delta L is half into 2 meters into 40 by EA into 2 plus 2 third of 2. How much? 40 by EA into, that is 3 to 6. 6 plus 4, 10 by 3, yeah? Correct, na?
Yes, sir.
400 by 3 EA. That is the delta L. That is the downward deflection of the cantilever if there is no simply supported beam. If there is no simply supported beam, obviously delta L, that means tip of the cantilever, will deflect this much if there is no simply supported beam. So R, but R support it is getting. Okay. The cantilever is getting how much support reaction? R reaction. Because of R support reaction, what would be the upward deflection? Tell me, what is the upward deflection due to R? RL cube by 3A.
3A.
RL cube by 3A. So delta RMO. R into L cube. 4 cube by 3A. That is 64 R by 3A. So final ga meeku ee simply supported beam vachesi ila deflect avutund anamata. Adhe anta chundi ila meeku ee simply supported beam ila deflect ayyintundi kada. So obvious ga ee beam kuda ఇలా డిఫెక్ట్ అవ్వాలి కదా. సో అంటే టిప్ ఆఫ్ ద క్యాంటిలివర్ ఈస్ రెస్టింగ్ ఆన్ సింప్లీ సపోర్టెడ్ బీమ్, దట్స్ వై డెల్టా ఎస్, డెల్టా ఎస్ మీన్స్ సింప్లీ సపోర్టెడ్ బీమ్ డిఫ్లెక్షన్, దట్ ఈస్ ఆర్ ఇంటూ ఎల్ క్యూబ్. ఎల్ క్యూబ్ మీన్స్ 6 క్యూబ్ బై 48 ఏ, విచ్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 6 క్యూబ్ మీన్స్ 216 216 ఆర్ బై 48 EI, otherwise cancelling with 6, 36 R by 8, or otherwise 18 by 4,
9 by 2
R. So now compatibilities, if there is no simply supported beam, it would be delta L. But some simply support beam is there, or reaction it is getting. That's why delta L minus delta R is net is now delta S. That is the compatibility condition. So delta L is 400 by 3 EI minus delta R is 64 R by 3 EI. Okay, which is equal to 9 R by 2 EI. 2 EA. Okay, so solving this we get R 400 by 3, anyway EA gets cancelled, equal to 9 by 2 plus 64 by 3 R, or otherwise R equal to 400 by 3 by 9 by 2 plus 64 by 3, which is equal to 400 by 3 by 6 is LCM 27 plus 128, which is equal to 400 by 3 into 6 by 155. How much? 800 by 150, how much? And that's in the 800 by 150.
5.16.
Huh?
5.16.
5.16 kilonewtons is the what is the prop reaction R? So obviously now we need to find reactions of simply supported beam. That means here R by 2, R by 2. So now R by 2 is nothing but 5.16 by 2, 2.58, 2.58 kilonewtons. This also 2.58 kilonewtons. So like this, we need to apply this method of consistent deformations to these problems. Okay. So now the problem system change in low. Assignment. Kilonewtons, 3 meter, 2 meter. K equal to EA equal to 10,000 kilonewton meter square. K equal to 8L³. Okay, 2000 kilonewton per meter. Find prop reaction. Next step. P L by 2 K of the string equal to 4A by L³. ఇంతకు ముందు మనం అలానే పెట్టామా 4A. ఓకే నెంబర్ 2 ఫైండ్ prop reaction. Next third problem. K equal to 2A by L³ UDL W kilonewton per meter L by 2. Find prop reaction. Next step. M couple L and A K equal to 2A by L³. Find prop reaction. Kilonewton per meter, 3 meter EA. EA equal to 10,000 kilonewton meter square. AB, if support six by 6 mm. Find RB. Okay. If I problem change consistent deformations meter. Not just one. Support the grid deflection and colon matter. ఇంకేం డౌట్స్ ఉన్నాయి ఇందులో?
సార్ అది 6 mm అంటే జి లాగా తీసుకోవాలి కదా?
ఏదమ్మా
అది లాస్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ లో 6 mm జి కదా సార్?
అంతే అమ్మా అంతే అంతే. మీటింగ్ ఎండ్ అయిపోతుంది, మళ్ళీ స్టార్ట్ చేద్దాం.
ఓకే,
40 minute లిమిటేషన్ ఉంది. నెక్స్ట్ మళ్ళీ స్టార్ట్ చేసి కొత్త టాపిక్స్ స్టార్ట్ చేద్దాం.